Hi, brothers and sisters. Good morning. This is my Sunday's best for all of you. The biography of Padre Pio of Pietrelcina in Italy. Last September 23, we have celebrated his feast day, and that is the his death anniversary also. He is the kind of priest to be followed, not only para sa mga kaparian nato sa tibuok kalibutan, kundi tanang katauhan. Anya example sa sufferings. Doon na siya mga stigmata, itawag og stigmata, mga wounds sa iyang palad, just like Jesus, mga ginail, gikuan sa cross din, sa iyang tiil, o sa uban pang party sa iyang lawas. So, akong basahon karon ang iyang autobiography. Actually, I started doing the novena and invoked Padre Pio, one of my saints, favorite saints, last the day one of my kidney surgery. It was successful, and I'm doing it almost every day. So, this is the biography of Padre Pio. I hope you will have a time to pause and listen. Saint Padre Pio, known as Francisco Forgione, was born on May 25, 1887 in Pietrelcina, Italy. Even as a child, Francisco has already shown signs of extraordinary gift of grace. And at the age of 5, he dedicated his life to God. From his early childhood, he showed a kind of recollection of spirit and love for the religious life. His mother described him as a quiet child who, from his earliest years, loved to go to church to pray. He was said to have been able to see and communicate with not only his guardian angel, but also with Jesus and the Virgin Mary. He was admitted to the Capuchin novitiate at age 16, and was admired by his superiors and his fellow students for his exemplary behavior and his piety. On August 10, 1910, at the age of 23, Padre Pio was ordained to the priesthood. His parishioners were deeply impressed by his piety, and one by one they began to come to him, seeking his counsel. For many, many years, even a few moments in his presence proved to be a life-changing experience. Father Eusebio Note, Padre Pio's assistant for many years, described him as a man who had become a prayer. He prayed the rosary almost continually every day. He had a special mission to the souls in purgatory and encouraged everyone to pray for them. He used to say, "We must empty purgatory," quotation. "We must empty purgatory with our prayers." To someone who asked him what legacy he wished to leave to his spiritual children when he died, Padre Pio briefly replied, "My child, the rosary." Throughout his entire life, he suffered from poor health, but this did not in any way discourage him. He ordered all his bodily sufferings to God. He offered, rather, all of his bodily sufferings to God as a sacrifice to help save souls. He experienced many spiritual sufferings as well. The marks of the stigmata appeared on Padre Pio's body on September 20, 1918, while he was praying before a crucifix after Mass. He was 21 years old and became the first stigmatized priest in the history of the Catholic Church. Or rather, in the church. With resignation and serenity, He bore the wounds for 50 years. In addition, God endowed Padre Pio with many extraordinary charisms, including the gift of healings, bilocation, prophecy, miracles, the gift of conversions, the ability to read hearts, the gift of tongues, the ability to speak and understand languages that he had never studied, and the fragrance which emanated from his wounds and which frequently announced his invisible presence. When a friend once questioned him about these charisms, Padre Pio said, and I quote, "You know, thee are a mystery to me too." Although he received more than his share of spiritual gifts, he never sought them. Never felt worthy of them. He never put the gifts before the giver. He always remained humble, constantly at the disposal of the Almighty God. His day began at 2:30 in the morning, when he would rise to begin his prayers and make his preparation for Mass. He was able to carry on a busy apostolate with only a few hours of sleep each night. He ate very little, 300 to 400 calories a day, and that his fellow priest stated it was not enough even to keep a child alive. Celebrating Mass and hearing confessions, he worked 19 hours a day. Remember, for all the priests in the entire world, confessions that he's doing is 19 hours a day. He very rarely left the monastery and never took even a day's vacation from his grueling schedule in 51 years. He never read a newspaper or listened to the radio. He cautioned his spiritual children against watching television. He gave a new spirit to hospitals by founding one which he called the Home for the Relief of Sufferings, quotation. He saw the image of Christ in the poor, the sufferings, and the sick, and gave himself particularly to them. He once said, and I quote, "Bring God to all those who are sick. This will help them more than any other remedy." Serene and well prepared, he surrendered to Sister Death on September 23, 1968, at the age of 81. His last words were, quotation, "Jesus, Maria, Jesus, Mary," which he repeated over and over, until he breathed his last. He had often declared, quotation, "After my death, I will do more. My real mission will begin after my death." The prayer groups that Padre Pio established have now spread throughout the world. And in 1971, Pope Paul VI, speaking to the superiors of the Capuchin order, said of Padre Pio, quotation, "What fame he had! How many followers from around the world! Why? Was it because he was a philosopher, a scholar, or was it because he had means at his disposal? No, it was because he said Mass humbly." Heard again. This is the words of St. John Paul II. "It is because he said Mass humbly, not because of his being famous." heard confessions from morning until night, and was a marked representative of the stigmata of our Lord. He was truly a man of prayer and sufferings. In one of the largest liturgies in Vatican's history, Pope John Paul II canonized Padre Pio on June 16, 2002. During his homily, John Paul II called how in 1947, as a young priest, he journeyed from Poland to make his confessions to Padre Pio. Open quotation, prayer and charity. This is the most concrete synthesis of Padre Pio's teaching, close quotation, the Pope said. Brothers and sisters, that is the lesser than 1 minute autobiography of Padre Pio. But there are lots of stories of his miracles. Then I will repeat so that ang ato mga kaparian, dili lamang sa ako mga higala, sa mga kaila, kundi kaparian sa tibok kalibutan, na inaot-unta nga doon natay pagsunod sa atong vow, sa atong pagkapari. A part lang unta sa mga sufferings ni Padre Pio. One, ang paghatag sa misa kay di man nato pampresensya ni Jesus kay kamuman ang mag-consecrate sa lawas ug dugo ni Kristo nga tinuod gyud real. Not unta nga kay daghan kay kog mga amigo nga nakaila sa ako nga nakaat na nga kabalo sila nga na ako'y connections mga maayong relasyon sa mga kaparian labi na sa Cagayan de Oro mga tana nga kuan sila mga report nga mga dili maayo ako silang giingnan nga iampo lang ato mga kaparian kun do naman galin mga nangasayop kun nawala sa dalan nga mga karnero nakakawas sa kural pag misa kinanglan sagrado ta before ta matug misa nya kinanglan sab ada atay kuan panahon sa pag kuan sa Ginoo kanang confession na atay permita excited confession og uban pang mga calling mga missions nato kay kining atong mission mao man ang pag propagate sa good news and act on it. Hinautunta, I'm not addressing this to the priest only but to all people around because there's only one reward, salvation, heaven. So thank you for listening. Ito po si Loyal Paasa, hindi nagpapaasa, habang may buhay, may pag-asa. Happy Sunday. Bye-bye.